Okay, so here we're being asked to find the equation of a line that passes through a certain point, 3, 2, minus 5, and we're told it's perpendicular to both this vector A, 1, 0, minus 1, and the vector B, minus 1, 5, 2. So before I even begin, the second you see that you need to find the equation of a line, you should automatically know there's two pieces of information you need. You need a point. And you need a direction vector. So we need a point on the line, and we need a direction vector for the line. So let me actually just abbreviate this direction vec. Okay, and this should just be like automatic now. This is very important. If you're looking for a line, you need to find these two pieces of information. Okay, so in our case, they gave us a point that the line passes through. So for us, one is done. Point is 3, 2, minus 5. Part two, though, finding a direction vector is going to be a little bit harder. So let's focus on that a little bit. But before I do that, let me just also say, once you know the point and the direction vector, the last thing that you do is you just use the general equation of a line, which is R equals R0 plus a scalar variable t, stands for time, times your direction vector. So this is the general equation of a line. So this is kind of like your third step, I guess. You find your point, you find your direction vector, and then you plug it into here. Now, of course, this R naught is a position vector for your point. So it will be a vector, but it will have the exact same numbers as the point you found. Okay, so for us, how do we find a direction vector? Well, we kind of know the direction of the line implicitly with words. We know that the direction is going to be the direction that's perpendicular to both A and B. But in order to get that as a vector, how do we do that? Well, let me draw you something here. So I'm not trying to actually draw this in three space. I'm just kind of drawing this abstractly. But if this is A and this is B, then how do we get a vector that's perpendicular to both A and B? Well, what we can do is we can take their cross product. And their cross product, A cross B in this case, if we use the right-hand rule, we'll see that A cross B gives us the one pointing up. Then this vector, A cross B, will be perpendicular to both A, and it will be perpendicular to B. All right. It's maybe too big of a perpendicular symbol. Sorry, let me struggling with this. The easiest part of this is which is just drawing a perpendicular symbol. There we go. There's one, and then there's another one. Okay, so that vector A there is perpendicular, or sorry, A cross B is perpendicular to both A and B. And so that's all we needed. We have now a vector that's in the direction perpendicular to A and B, so we can use that as our direction vector. Okay, so how do we do that? We have to do the cross product of A cross B. So let's go ahead and set that up. This is still part of finding a direction vector. So A cross B And how do we do this? We do this determinant I, J, K. And A was, I think, 1, 0, minus 1. Is that correct? Let me go back up and check what these vectors were. 1, 0, minus 1, and B is minus 1, 5, 2. Okay, and we just compute this and What do we get for I? Well, if you've never seen this before, just briefly I'll tell you. To figure out what the I component is, or the x component, the piece in the direction of x, you cross out the row I is in, you cross out the column I is in, and you do this fancy multiplication where you do 0 times 2, which gives us 0, and then you do minus 1 times 5. So let me just show you that. So 0 times 2 is 0, minus, and then minus 1 times 5 is minus 5. And then we're going to do minus the j piece, which we cross out the row. Let me just do this real quick again. We cross out the row j is in the column, and we do the same thing. 1 times 2 will give us 2, and then minus 1 times minus 1. So let's do that. So this is 1 times 2, minus, and then minus 1 times minus 1 is positive 1. And then finally we'll do the k component. And so we cross out the row and column k's in, and we do 1 times 5 is 5, minus 0 times minus 1 is 0. And this simplifies to 5i minus j, or 1j if you prefer, plus 5k. And if we want to write this a little bit differently, this is the same thing as 5 minus 1 and 5. Okay, so what is this? This is A cross B, and from our discussion above, A cross B is in the direction that's perpendicular to A and perpendicular to B. So in other words, this is our direction vector D. Okay, so back to the beginning of our discussion, what did we need? Let me go back up. We needed a point and a direction vector. We were told a point. It was 3, 2, minus 5. We just figured out a direction vector. It was our A cross B, which turned out to be 5, minus 1, 5. And so now we just use step 3, which is just using that formula. So 3, we have... The final answer is, the equation of the line is r equals, and then we just take our point and convert it to a position vector. So this is just 3, 2, minus 5, plus our variable t. This is just a scalar, just a real number, stands for time, times our direction vector, which is 5, minus 1, 5. I'm sorry if that's going off the screen a little bit there. Okay, and that's the vector equation of the line. So the hard part here was finding the direction vector, but it wasn't too hard. It was just one simple cross product got the job done. So if you understand the cross product and the fact that it gives you a perpendicular vector, then this should have been relatively easy to be able to find that direction vector. Okay, so let's just, the last thing we'll do in for, we'll take a minute and just simplify and write the parametric equations. So this ends up being 3 plus 5t, 2 minus t in the y component, and minus 5 plus 5t in the z component. So all I did was multiply the t through and then add these two vectors together. And so from here, we can easily read off the parametric equations. We get x is 3 plus 5t, just reading off the x component. Y is 2 minus t, reading off the y component. And z is minus 5 plus t. Oh, sorry, plus 5t, just reading off the z component. And there you have it, the parametric equations. Okay, see you in the next video.